Planet Restoration. Fix the frequency. Fix the frequency. Planet Restoration. Fix the frequency. Fix the frequency. Turn the light to shine. Fast with the slow, yeah. Hey, where we go, no one knows, yeah. Let's restore up the globe, yeah. Yeah, right. Planet Restoration. Fix the frequency. Fix the frequency. Planet Restoration.
Grateful to connect like this at this time to inspire and inform and connect ourselves in new and different ways.
Mm-hmm. Right on time.
Right on time.
Right on vibration.
Very special moment, this inaugural broadcast of Planet Restoration. Fix the frequency. Going in PR live. Live to the whole world. Going in live. And I know that as time progresses and we get our facilitation together, we'll be joined by many people worldwide, and we're looking forward to having some dynamic guests in the very near future to join us on this this amazing journey.
For real. Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of fun. I mean, we got some great ones we wanna bring forward. Great minds, and a lot of solutions, you know?
That's right.
This whole thing is going to be very solution-centered. And, I think together, you know, we can do great things.
For sure.
Unquestionably.
So it's interesting because obviously, many people around the world, a third of the world's people, are being forced to quarantine right now. We know that that's actually happening in real time. And what's interesting about that is it is causing people, even though they call it social distancing, actually social connecting is happening in a way like never before. Because people are left with no choice but to come together, even though they have to physically distance, they can socially connect. And that's what we're looking forward to taking advantage of in these moments when we have people's attention in ways where, you know, we've all been so busy in the world for so long, we haven't had the chance, even against our will, to, you know, sit back and put attention to something new.
Exactly.
It's going to be
impressed and to really center, focus.
Right.
And I think to have a moment beyond chasing a dollar to reflect on what am I here? What is my mission? What is my purpose?
Mm.
You know?
For true.
I know, you know, the world hasn't come to a complete stop, though, pretty much to a degree. So it's a great time to have that introspection.
Indeed it is, man. So as we embark on this, you want to give a little background on PR, on the inspiration, on what even brings us here?
Exactly. Well, Planet Restoration is an organization that Makua Ray, Taj and I have been building on for the last over 10 years now. And it's based in arts, culture, media, and just, it's in the name, you know what I'm saying? Everything restorative, you know, for the planet. And yeah, so that's a little spell, though. You can go in a little better, a little more in depth.
Well, I'm just wondering, even why does it matter? Like, why does this even matter right now? Like, we've been doing this for, you know, over a decade, like you mentioned, but, you know, why now? And why is it even relevant? Because there's so much information coming at people all the time. There's so many things to put your attention to. So why is this even relevant to people?
Exactly. Well, I feel like one key thing about it is that it's a bridge. It's a bridge. It's a bridge to the people. A bridge to the urban world, you know what I'm saying? A bridge of information that has kind of been sectored off. And right now, we need more than ever to, like, harmonize, to find our respective harmonies and harmonize together. And so I think Planet Restoration endeavors to bridge that gap where sustainability or regenerative living and culture and all things healing of the planet, where there's a bridge, you know, to the urban world and to the young ones and ones, you know, to really be able to connect in a way that not everyone can, you know?
Right on. That sounds right. So amplify regenerative arts and culture, basically.
Exactly.
Give a platform to it. In a time where we're going to be obviously made to put our focus on other things, while at the same time, we don't want to lose the momentum that's been building around this regenerative momentum, this force of creativity, innovation, transformation on the planet, because things are off the rails right now. Things are off target in a way, but at the same time, maybe the current situation is also serving to put us in focus in a way like never before.
Exactly.
So when we talk about fix the frequency, like perhaps that's part of the message, is to recognize that in order to fix something must actually be broken. So how we got to where we are, we have to first admit that, you know, things have been a little off the mark, broken.
Exactly.
Hmm.
And two, that makes me think of the frequency. As in, you know, we see how media is changing daily, you know, and
right.
It's like where we used to change the channel and tune into these frequencies every day, things are falling apart. It's not the same as it was, and it's almost like the playing field has been leveled.
Talk more about that. What do you mean by that?
I said that in a way to say, like, at one point, it mattered that Oprah was in her studio, wherever she was at, with all the cameras and lights. Now, everybody's at home on their phone and doing their broadcasts. Even Jimmy Fallon, Trevor Noah, they're doing their shows from home. Just like we all can, pretty much. You know what I'm saying? D-Nights, one-to-ones.
Right.
It's a playing field that's leveled now. So that's what I mean by that.
Okay. Yeah, that's right. That's right. So we have the ability to be the media that we actually want to see, what we actually want to amplify or create in the world.
Bring forth those frequencies.
So speaking of the frequency, I think it's interesting when we say that, obviously, we mean something very specific as well. It's the frequency, obviously, the feeling, the vibration that we're carrying, that we share. But then we also go a little deeper when we begin to talk about concepts of the calendar and the timing frequency that we've been kind of trapped in for well over four centuries. And it's among the many things that we're being caused to actually question now more actively as we really look at, you know, how do we get where we are and where do we want to go from here? Where do we really see ourselves going? And so,
exactly. As well as the sound frequencies too,
which
that goes together.
Exactly. The sound frequencies. So we have the opportunity then to really look at who are the solutionaries in these fields, who are the ones out here on the planet that aren't necessarily getting the cameras and the highlights and the, you know, all of the attention put on them. But that's where we want to come in and have some impact. We want to be effective in that way to actually put a spotlight on, to amplify the good work happening. So the people don't lose hope and don't lose track of the progress that's been made so far in the effort to regenerate and transform our global societal situation.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And that makes me think of how it feels like this American culture is a type of culture where it's like everybody has to start from scratch, you know?
Mm.
It's not one where we stand on the shoulders and we keep getting higher type of thing. So I say that to say, like you said, there's a trail of wisdom and we can walk that trail. We don't have to, you know, start from scratch.
That's right. Yeah, we definitely have had the coordinates laid out for us for quite a long time. We, you know, and the interesting thing is we've been moving so fast in the world, we haven't really been checking in with those coordinates. We've been just moving automatically because we're caught up in a frequency that we're not necessarily aware of. So
exactly.
The current situation is causing us to actually take better account of what matters most. Because this is obviously something on a planetary scale like we've never seen before, particularly because everybody is so connected and information is so available that we really don't have an excuse not to know. We don't have an excuse. We really just have to be disciplined and oriented in what really matters most. You know?
For real. Exactly.
Yeah. So
I'm wondering if we can see comments from our Facebook page.
Maybe. Let me see if we got any comments.
Okay, Darshanya.
Darshanya's.
He says.
What?
Not?
Yeah, let me see what we can do about that. Let me see how we navigate that. Blessed love, y'all.
Yeah,
we look forward to having Darshanya on an episode here in the very near now, because she is a dynamic solutionary and artist, a mother and leader and yogini and so much more, you know. And it is an exciting time to be able to amplify and celebrate each other too, in these ways. Because I know you know many, many solutionaries. I know a lot of solutionaries. You know, that's the company we keep, frankly. So
exactly,
it's good to be able to actually...
And really, to pull in community in a way where we're united. Because over time, we've been part of so many communities.
Truly.
And... you know, there's a focus of energy, and then we dissipate. Everybody goes their ways, move on to another community, boom, boom, boom. So it's like we're all here now, and it's time to pull in.
Be here now.
Exactly. Together.
Be here now.
By the grace.
By the grace. For sure. I want to figure out how we can actually see some of the messages coming into the Facebook page right now. Give me a moment. You might have that open too, so you might be the one to support that. Yeah, big love, big love. Big love to our sister. Giving thanks.
Yeah, I see it on Facebook.
Yeah. I'm looking at it. So, I know that we've also experienced some dynamic transitions in the past several days from our communities. You know, really dynamic leaders, seers, visionaries, healers. You know, and I know we want to bring light to that and celebrate life of these amazing elders that we've had the fortune of knowing their work, of coming up under them in many ways, and they've influenced countless people around the world. And namely, I'm speaking of Dr. Laila Africa, for one, and Baba Credo Mutwa as well, you know. And I think it might be fitting if we go ahead and actually hear from the voices of these elders. What do you think?
Nice.
Maybe move into some of that, share some of that. I really want to, dive right in, actually. And
that'd be great.
Yeah, I think it's powerful to be able to reflect on the wisdom, and that our elders be not forgotten as we move forward. As things move so fast, we definitely have to practice Sankofa. We got to stay in the attitude of gathering the wisdom that we've gained, that we've come up, as you said before, on the shoulders of great ones. So we want to keep it alive, you know, for sure, as things progress.
Exactly. And some of these great ones, they live on through their work.
Absolutely. You know? Absolutely.
So let's not let it go in vain.
Nah, not at all. And that's the key right now.
Utilize and activate.
That's the key. That is key, my brother.
For sure.
So with that said, I want to go ahead and play some clip here you have. And I want to thank you as well for the beautiful production that people are hearing in the background. Many people know. I mean, we want to get a little bit into that as well about your background, your story. You know, I think this is a real opportunity for storytelling and sharing so people get to know the human behind the controls. You know, the human under the headphones, so they can have a better appreciation for that connected story as well. But we'll get into some of that. But thanks again for that production. It really, really matters. And we'll go ahead. Step by step, man. I mean, it's an honor and a privilege to definitely vibe with you, brother. So
likewise,
on that tip, yeah, for sure. So we're going to go ahead and play a little audio here from Dr. Laila Africa. And let's just give thanks. Ashe.
I just want to discuss a few things with you. We're all under a lot of stress. We get a lot of stress for what's going on socially. We get stress from the news reports about crime, about murder, about terrorist threats. So we're getting a lot of stress. We get stress from our relationships, our jobs, going back and forth to work, or back and forth not finding work. Either way, we're getting a lot of stress. And there are things we can do about it. We can pretend that it doesn't exist, which will not help you whatsoever. Your body reacts to stress. That much you must know. You hold a lot of tension in your muscles, which can cause your back to be out of line. Stress can cause you to eat things you should not eat. You may have a lovely love affair with McDonald's and other creatures that harm you. Stress can alter your diet. It can have impact on your relationship. Usually, when the economy gets bad and stressful, divorces go up, breaking up relationships increase, children's behavior misbehave. All of these things are a result of stress, and we must find a solution. a natural solution aside from the junk food, aside from the alcohol, aside from the drugs, aside from the sex addiction, aside from the game addiction, aside from all of these text messaging addictions, we need to find an alternative to these stresses. And nature is the best way to go. That means you must learn to deep breathe, exercise, do relaxing times in your day. Take time out to relax yourself and to love yourself outside of the stress. Now, I'm not going to say it cures everything, but it will help if you're more mindful of the impact of stress on you physically, emotionally, mentally, spiritually, and with your relationships, and of course with your diet.
There's a lot of great scholars in the cultural community, in that whole scene. And I feel like just when you feel like you've researched all of them or heard all of the information, there's more, you know? Mm. Because just researching some of Dr. Layla Africa's work, he's like, he's going in on so much and he's breaking it down clearly. Like, it's amazing. You know, how much, what wealth of information is there.
Mm.
So I would just encourage ones and ones to go in, research, and have a pen and pad, you know what I'm saying, with you. Take notes, you know?
Take notes.
On things that you can activate, you know, in your life.
Mm-hmm. I think that's right. School is definitely in session.
Real.
School is definitely in session.
Exactly. And that knowledge has not expired.
No, not at all. We are definitely in it.
Yeah.
In it, for sure.
All the way.
So with that said, I want to switch our attention over to the other elder we mentioned. Baba Kriddo Mutwa, who is renowned, what a phenomenal life, 98 years, made his transition yesterday, I believe, and highly regarded as a Sangoma, a high priest of the highest order possible. Really.
Exactly.
You know, Sanusi.
Just the highest, you know, just griot of the highest order, whole nine.
For sure. And so.
and I would say, like, I would liken it to the, I think they call it the Library of Alexandria.
Mm.
Like, once it burns down, you know, hopefully certain things were passed on that needed to be passed on.
Yeah.
Because he's that.
Truly. Truly. So, I know you have some audio from the revered Kriddo Mutwa as well, some powerful audio. So I'm going to go ahead and roll that right now. So powerful. And I'm really grateful that we actually have elders in our community, teachers of ours, who have a direct relationship with him. And we're going to invite them on in future broadcasts to share some reflections of their time, even recent times that they've spent with him. You know, very, very special. Very special. So let's go in and check a little bit of this audio here from the one and only Kriddo Mutwa. Give thanks.
My friends, I salute you all in the name of peace and in the name of the common brotherhood and sisterhood of humankind. My name is Kriddo Mutwa, a native of South Africa. I have an urgent appeal to make to the whole world, to organizations such as the African Union, to organizations such as the United Nations, to help me in a strange problem that I have. My problem is not personal. My problem is to be allowed to do my duty to all humankind.
This is the story, a story you find throughout Africa. There was once a time when the blue sky was invisible, when the whole world was covered with mist, when you could not see the sun as it is now, you only saw it as a splash of white light moving slowly across the sky. At that time, there was an eternal drizzle every day of the year. At that time, people could not see the stars. People only saw the trees growing, trees which were very, very big. There was no desert at that time, only jungle everywhere where you went. At that time, sir, people were what we call in Zulu, ngubili. A human being was both male and female in one body. And out of the sky, one day, came terrible objects. They were like gigantic bombs made of huge gleaming gold. They were shaped like bows without strings, and they were bigger than the biggest mountains. They came out of the sky, bringing great noise, black smoke, and fire with them. And out of those huge objects came them. At that time, sir, human beings could not speak. We had no gift of language at that time. And people had, however, great mental power. A man would go into the bush and, using the power of his mind, actually call out an animal which he wanted to hunt and kill for his children. And the animal would appear and kneel down before the man, and the man would kill the animal and take it home. But when the Chitauli arrived in Africa, they told our people that they were gods and that they were going to give us human beings great gifts on one condition. We had to worship them and accept them as our creators. Some told our people that they were our elder brothers and that this earth had produced them generations ago. And they said they had come back to the green womb of their mother and that they were going to make us into gods.
Wow, feels right to definitely take the time to acknowledge these great ones, the voices of the elders, for sure. And there's so much wisdom we have to share from our elders as in future broadcasts. You know, I'm looking forward to really going through the archives of this wisdom.
Exactly.
Resonant wisdom.
Because I really feel like, you know, this is like a soul food that's really needed, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's a soul food.
Food for the soul.
Right now.
You're getting a little static on your end too, so maybe it's me.
Test, test, can you hear me?
It's definitely on your end.
Okay.
It's like static.
Yeah, it might just be my computer.
Yeah.
Hang on.
Use your phone.
It's running.
Phone. Phone in the future.
No, it's gonna cut. It's not gonna be. Yeah, I'll use phone next time.
Yeah, we can.
Good to know.
We can always do this. Then we can just.
That works.
In the meantime, we'll just keep it like this.
Yeah.
But yeah, exactly. So if you want to.
For the sake of Corona, not for being too close.
Yeah, social distancing. We're doing it.
Social distancing. Cyber social distance.
Not like distancing. This. Too close. Too close. Too close. There we go. That's more like it. All right. Oh, boy. But nah, seriously, it is important for people definitely to stay at home. We invite you to stay at home right now because this is not a time to be out and about. That does not make sense.
Yeah. And
they say LA is like, you know, 7 days behind what's happening in New York. Exactly. So we definitely want to alert our friends and family, our loved ones, to, you know, take it seriously. Because it whatever the origins of what we're now experiencing, we're now experiencing it. And it's not fake news. It's really happening. Mm-hmm. So we definitely want to encourage people to take that seriously and stay in the house.
And symbolically, it's like we have so much belief and fear that, okay, it's all going to fall apart if we don't stay in the system, keep the system going as it has been. Though it's like sometime life says sit your ass down.
This might be one of those times. That's funny.
And it's like you can go against the grain if you want to, as much as you want. Though it's gonna keep, you know, pulling out a chair for you. Sit down.
Truly.
Set your fears aside.
And go sit on down.
Sit
somewhere.
Down. Something new is happening here. Something new happening. Be okay with it. You know, we'll make it through the other side. On the other side,
that's right.
There'll be something there. New.
Exciting and new. Like the love boat.
Exciting and new.
Like the love boat.
Exactly.
Although that might not be the best reference to make.
Maybe not, but.
Yeah. You know. We got to definitely find the levity in all the gravity of the situation. Yeah. So, more levity, more love,
gravity.
More comedy, lightheartedness, loving kindness. We're, you know, that's definitely important at these times. All right. So let's give this a shot, see how it feels.
Let's see how it goes, how it feels. Give thanks, family. One love, one light. So as Dr. Layla Africa said, like the stress affects our body, affects everything. So we want to try to de-stress, decompress. Take a deep breath. Feel the vibes. I'm going to share this prayer with you all and just feel the vibes with me. O divine love source, I am. Honor and appreciation for the sacred breath of life. And the precious life force bringing forth life.
Honor and love to the ones who came before us. All the great mothers, fathers, grandmothers, grandfathers, kings, queens, masters, and mystics. We intend to glorify and honor your greatness. In the spirit of sincere love and peace, we energize divine under, over, and understanding. We energize sacred knowing, recall of all of our greatness. Energizing and affirming the recall of all of our good fortune. Through love and appreciation of the beauty of Love Source, I magnify, glorify, and radiate as a regenerative unit of divine energy in motion, calling forth the strength, discipline, humility, focus, zeal, and clarity for the sake of alignment and the works to be done. With the might and power of all beings and spirits conspiring for good and righteousness, I call forth the love light source to shine, glow, and abide in this space as a pulse of love, joy, tranquility, and peace. Radiating all about us, radiating this love from the heart throughout the body, room, house, or apartment, block, city, country, continent, world, cosmos. Feel this love radiating. As we feel regenerated from this love energy, pour into our day with the knowing and affirming of love, light, reality as our basis. Reflecting and connecting with more love light units and shining forth the love light throughout the world. The affirmation or chant for the day would be, I radiate as a regenerative unit of love light. Let that settle in your being. Let that, you know, just saturate into you. I radiate as a regenerative unit of love light. I radiate as a regenerative unit of love light. Give thanks, family. One love. Be at peace.
All right. That was beautiful.
Now that?
That was beautiful. That was beautiful. I radiate as a unit.
I radiate as a regenerative unit.
There we go.
Regenerative.
That's important. Not just any kind of unit.
Like a living unit.
But like a living regenerative unit.
I radiate as a regenerative unit
in our mission
light
to amplify regenerative arts and culture, planet restoration.
Exactly.
Yeah. So exactly. On that note, I definitely want to, again, I want to honor that amazing audio that we intended to play from Stick about Dr. Laila Africa and you know, share his testimony, because I think it's beautiful when you hear ones and ones, you know, who you've witnessed grow and evolve and understand a lot of the source of their inspiration and information that really put them right on the path. And again, you know, knowing the transition that we've just witnessed in the communities that have been affected by Dr. Africa's passing, you know, it's a good thing to honor him.
Yeah, so this is Stick from Dead Prez, RBG Fit Club. My first encounter with Dr. Africa and his teachings of holistic health was in Brooklyn, New York. I came across African Holistic Health book, and I had caught gout in my leg. And I had been drinking, smoking, and living that lifestyle for a while. And I woke up one morning with gout in my leg, and my wife introduced me to a vegan diet, Queen Fua, and Dr. Africa's teachings on holistic health. And I was able to heal naturally, transition to a plant-based diet, got into martial arts and running and yoga. And I'm 20-some years clean and deep, you know. And so Dr. Africa's impact on my life has been personally transforming. And I've seen, you know, countless people in our community benefit, you know, from culturally relevant, you know, teachings around holistic health. So I salute him as a general in the health army.
Primarily what we're dealing with is energy. We're dealing with energy as we call it, qifat. Energy is generally classified based on what we call in African science the male and female principle. The male principle being science and the female principle being art. You cannot have art without science. If you play the piano, you enter mathematics. You cannot have art without science. You cannot have science without art. The male and female principle. It takes two to tango, as the old folks would say.
Powerful testimony right there. So I want to definitely big up Stick for that. And again, he gave a wonderful shout out to Queen Afua as well as being instrumental to his path. And I look forward to having her on a future upcoming episode as a guest. You know, we run in very similar circles, concentric circles. So one of the things I'm excited about for the broadcast in the future is our segment, Time is Art, because we're going to be able to really present art from artists like our friend Darshania down there in St. Croix, who has some amazing music and wonderful music videos. I look forward to presenting some of that, having some interviews with the artists like her, Georgia Ann Muldrow. Prayerfully, one day we'll be able to connect with her on The Vibe, too. And so many other artists. I mean, this has really been our lives, all our life. So we have the opportunity to go ahead and showcase the people who we're inspired by, the people who we can find and retrieve or receive information from at these kind of times. News you can use, you know, because there is a risk of people obviously, you know, succumbing to fear and doubt and concern, and rightfully concerned. But the fact of the matter is, fear is not the frequency. And we want to fix that frequency through inspiration and information. And that's why we're here to do what we're here to do on the planet. And so I think we're going to probably wrap here in a few moments. We do have some wisdom from another elder bringing some divine feminine to the mix right now. You really queued up some wonderful information from an elder very close to us. And as we talked about the origin story for Planet Restoration, I think it's important to note that this initiative was inspired and born out of a gathering in 15 years ago, called Beyond the Global Divide, which was convened by our good brother Mike Ware and his mom, Audrey Scott Williams, who's been a longtime elder in my life, somebody who is very special to me. And in the way these circles work, she just 3 weeks ago was with Credo Mutua in South Africa, and has been very close with Credo and his wife, Virginia. And we have some incredible audio, though, something that I actually helped film and record, back in like 2009 or 10, maybe, during the Peace Walks. First was the Trail of Dreams World Peace Walk, and then the 13 moon walk for peace as well. And so there was a compilation of wisdom gathered from these various walks where I was able to help support some media and get some of the perspectives that Audrey was sharing from the walk. And through the guidance of her guides, Grandmothers of the Four Directions. So we want to go to some of that audio right now, bring some of that wisdom in as we begin to look forward to what's next. And I think, you know, without over-promising and under-delivering, we definitely plan to move forward with this broadcast and we refine it over the days ahead. Because, I mean, here we are, kind of a captive audience at this point. As we know, more and more people will tune in. We didn't even really advertise this or cue it up. We really just wanted to take it for a test run. But I think we've seen that we have something really special here. And we can bring in these gems, these pearls of wisdom, and we can create a platform to celebrate the artists who inspire and inform us and share that with the world and a more broad audience, as well as highlight some projects we're really excited about. I mean, initiatives happening all over the world, you know, projects that I'm personally connected to with my partner in Mexico, some really powerful regenerative things happening, habitat preservation. We're also excited to amplify and share more about the science of Agnihotra to heal the atmosphere with elders and community who've been practicing that Ayurvedic tradition for a very long time and have a lot of wisdom as a result. You know, tuning into the network of innovators and social entrepreneurs, inheritors who are looking at how to improve philanthropy through the work we've done with Nexus, which is a whole other connection and concentric circle in this tapestry. You know, we're really talking about the, you know,
as well as ways to protect ourselves from the bombardment of this 5G energy.
That's right. Exactly.
Which is a part of fixing the frequency.
Fix the frequency, that's right. And especially also, you know, the work around reforming the calendar and why calendar reform actually matters, why returning to a frequency of timekeeping, a natural timekeeping, and how that could be beneficial to us as a human family. I'm diving deeper into that with my good brother, Ruben Yinas, who's currently in Mexico and heading to Colombia back to his home soon. Even though the borders have been closed now, so he's in Mexico for another month or so. But he's doing some very important work tracking the Venus cycles, and I definitely want to make sure that we create space for him to share his important work of several years. This timekeeping work cannot be understated, and we kind of take it for granted, but that's one of the reasons we want to have this platform to really amplify things like this that are tending toward regenerative arts and culture to equip us with the tools we need, the news we can use, to get out of the fear and the blues at this time.
For real. But like you said, coming up under great elders, it's great to be able to share some of their wisdom, some of their life work. Because like ones and ones, like the great Dr. Rondo, he was such a powerful, amazing, great mind. And he has such great work that this stuff, like we need to pay more attention and like follow the trail, pick up the wisdom of these great ones and ones, because you know it's like the yellow brick road, you know.
Yeah, and we'll look forward to sharing more insights and perspectives on things happening on the planet today, right now, things that are impacting us. I mean, obviously, everybody's talking about coronavirus, so we don't need to overstate the overstated so much. Obviously, we are certainly sharing the message for people to stay at home, wash your hands, social distance, physical distance, socially connect online with us and others who are doing many great things. DJ D Nice, you shouted them out before, bringing an upful spirit to the people at this time, you know.
Exactly.
And we look to do something very similar.
And I gotta give a shout out. I gotta give thanks to my brother DJ D Nice, because I hit him up earlier today and asked him to give a shout out to my big brother Hakeem, tell him happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Hak.
And he texted me right back, like, yo, no problem, of course, man, I got you. So he just shouted him out like about an hour ago.
Yeah.
And I'm glad Hak was able to see that.
Yeah. So,
good, thanks, with love.
Big bro Hak.
Yeah.
And also blessed love on
cats
the...
Cats aren't too big to pick up.
Yeah, and blessed love to the family as well, you know? That's fantastic, you know? We're grateful to see everybody grow.
For real, yeah. Happy birthday, Hak.
For sure.
Love, step by step.
Whew, blessed love. So yeah, let's move into this audio from Audrey Scott Williams. And this audio is about 10 years old or more, but it's ever relevant today. And that's the beauty of the wisdom of our elders. This is always relevant, so we can play it anytime. And we'll continue to amplify indigenous wisdom, traditional elders, their knowledge, and their guidance, because it really does matter at this time especially. So with that said, we'll move into this, and then we'll come back and wrap up the show. Give thanks.
In one of our sessions the other night, the grandmothers gave us a mantra or a prayer, and that is, if you can love enough and trust enough and let go enough, that God can work miracles in you and through you. And then the humorous side of things, they said, why not? After all, you're not who you think you are anyway. What the messages combine attempt to tell us is that this is a time now where we've been talking about, we've all been in various ways studying and learning, thinking of what could happen if humanity could evolve. What does that really mean? And so today the grandmothers want to say that, you know, this is truly the moment. And while there are lots of things that can be expressing in our lives that appear to be negative or difficult or challenging or even chaotic, that in fact that is more the illusion than the things that are trying to break through. The challenge for us all right now is where we place our attention, what we give energy to. And if we place our attention on those things that are causing us to what we might say suffer or feel bad or to be challenged, we only accentuate that, because where we need to place our energy now is the potential openings that can happen. Our focus now, even in conversations, needs to be on what's being birthed here, because the cycle that has been put in place will inevitably fulfill itself. And that's what we must understand. Prophecy always fulfills itself when we miss the opportunity to see the signs and make the changes before the time of the prophecy is upon us. But this is a time when it's upon us. So what do? We focus on the fact that as we are rebirthing now, that the light is coming in. And when we say the light, that's the light of righteousness and justice and peace and harmony and love and compassion. All those things that will transform the world we live in, and what may come in a moment, in an instant, as change begets change begets change. The seeds are planted. Let us nurture those seeds. Let us build up and on fertile ground that which is coming forward. And from that, I'd like to say peace, be wise, be courageous, be loving, be compassionate. Be what it is you want to see in the world.
That's perfect wisdom from Audrey Scott Williams. I want to bring Bilal back into the mix here. What's up, B? Back on the scene.
Ooh, she laid it out.
Yeah, she did. That was powerful, man. Beautiful. And we look forward to having her on as a live guest here momentarily. We're also looking forward to having our brother Tuari Chika in a future episode and episodes providing the energetic weather forecast. He is a mystic astrologer, very talented, gifted seer and astrologer who can help provide some celestial perspective onto these trying times that we find ourselves navigating through.
So before we cut out,
yeah,
speaking of the forecast, can you lay out today for us as far as the...
The dream spell calendar.
The dream spell calendar.
And just to give people a little background, because it might be unfamiliar to a lot of people, the dream spell is based on universal mathematics, the frequency of 13 and 20. When we used to do a show called PR1320, in fact, and so, you know, that the effect of which was to help bring people into a greater galactic awareness, because the fact of the matter is, as Audrey indicated in that wisdom, the humor of this whole situation is we don't necessarily even know who we really are to begin with. So when we're looking at the things that are being impacted, we have to recognize that the truth and the essence of who we actually are in reality is not subject to these impacts. I'm going to let that sink in a little bit, because, you know, it's a high-minded wisdom to comprehend that we're more than just these bodies, that we're truly energy, we're vibration, we're consciousness. And when we begin to operate with a navigation of the coordinates of the dream spell time frequency and the natural time frequency, we begin to perceive and experience life as synchronicity, not as just cause-effect, but actually a magical tapestry of essence and energy that we are involved in, that we play in, that we do have an effect on, you know. But it's because we're operating from our creative potency, our potential, as creatives, truly. And so with that said, I'll read the energy for today. And we chose today to be the beta test for the show because it is the red planetary Earth day in that 260-day calendar, that galactic scope. And the affirmation says, I perfect in order to evolve, producing synchronicity. I seal the matrix of navigation with the planetary tone of manifestation. I am guided by the power of life force, by the red serpent Chichan Quetzcoatl, the Kundalini energy. So we can read that, we can break that down. These codes, these words are very, very potent, very deep. And when one begins to understand the mechanics of the timing frequency, begins to understand that flow, then the words become even more illuminating. I perfect in order to evolve. The purpose of Earth School is evolution. And while we're here, we get the opportunity of producing synchronicity when we operate with that planetary tone. It's about producing. And what are we producing in the case of the Earth is synchronicity. And we're sealing the matrix of navigation, which Earth is all about navigation. We have to really comprehend the bigger picture that we're actually on what some might refer to as the time ship Earth. The time ship. Earth is a living entity. It's a vessel that carries all of us. And as we think of it from a noospheric perspective, which is this coordinate, this information is really a noospheric perspective, the mind of Earth, the mental field surrounding the Earth, and our relationship to it. When we think of it through that lens, we recognize that this forced solitude, this forced non-activity or reduction in activity is actually a breather for the planet. You know, we'll come into more of the science in future episodes, but there are measured effects of everything in China being at a standstill for the past couple of months has reduced the pollution. And we can imagine that rolling effect across the planet while we're running up against this, the fact that the climate crisis is a real thing, has been real, and yet we've been, as a collective, unable to make necessary shifts and take necessary decisions to address it effectively. And if we don't do our due diligence, as they say, if you don't choose your change will choose you. And I think we find ourselves in a moment where our change has chosen us. So like you said earlier, B, we got to go sit down somewhere so Earth can heal. Earth can restore herself. We can actually move in a regenerative fashion. And that's the planetary tone of manifestation being guided by that Kundalini life force, that Quetzalcoatl energy. Mm-hmm. And again, all these codes have very deep potency. And, you know, we are only skimming the surface, obviously, but we'll be happy to provide resources for people's comprehension an appreciation of this information as we proceed to navigate this show. But it was important that we launched it today on KIN 257, out of 260 days. Today is number 257, the red planetary Earth, with our intention of manifesting this regenerative culture on planet Earth. You know,
bringing that
to full form and life. And we'll go deeper also into, you know, the relevance of the 1328 as we move forward with that. People can tune in to 13months28days.info for more information on the calendar. We can learn how the frequency 1328 is actually in our human body. 13 articulating joints, 28 phalanges when you count the 14 in each hand. 1328, we are natural time. It's embedded, encoded into our DNA. And I think it's done such that we would actually wake up and realize it on time, at a time when it was most needed. And I definitely think this is the time we're in. 2020, clear sight, clear vision, all that this invites, all the opportunity this creates. So that's just some insight into that. Thanks for asking.
Activation time, beautiful gift. Thanks, brother.
And activate in place, activate from within. It's not time to be necessarily active externally, but it's time to activate the internal qualities that we're walking around with. And largely we're inconsiderate to them. We're not aware of them as much. So it's an invitation to be present with oneself and with one's loved ones and to, you know, with the Creator.
And I would say too, like, I know for me personally, and I think just in the cultural community and just people in general, we amass lots and lots of information. So it's good to, now that we have some time, take something small out of that information that we can activate and utilize today.
Mm.
Just take one piece of that information, because we can have all this information. Unless we activate it within, it can lead to confusion, to more confusion, actually, if we're not utilizing it.
True.
So, and I would say, like, a little bit of utilization of one of them can snowball into, you know, a positive effect to something else, you know what I'm saying? And can get you on a path that you want to be on. Just something small, you know?
For sure. That's right.
To utilize, activate, rather if it's, you know, connecting with the earth in some way, you know, just something as basic as deep breathing in the mornings, you know what I'm saying, or your feet in the soil while deep breathing. Just some of the basics are some of the most powerful even.
And stay hydrated. I mean, right now, one of the best tips is to drink warm water, hot water with lemon, because we need to make our systems alkaline. And the fact is, that's what will help people navigate the pandemic, because the virus energy can't live in an alkaline environment. So we need to alkalinize our bodies. And one of the best and most effective ways is to increase your intake of lemon and warm water daily, mm-hmm. multiple times a day. People don't need to be really running around afraid. They just need, as you said, to activate these simple principles that we'll continue to amplify on the show. And we want to identify actionary and solutionary methods that people can go ahead and implement right away.
Exactly.
Doesn't cost a whole lot. You can have it for yourself and for your family. I mean, this is kind of news you can use and share with people. You know, and these are principles that our elders, like Dr. Laila Africa, was obviously very cognizant of and would instruct us as a holistic consciousness to do these very simple things, mm-hmm. to de-stress, to reduce stress in our lives. I mean, exactly. as we grow the show, we're going to get into more conversation about, you know, what are the impacts of the 5G phenomena that we're seeing happen. We know that it's coming online more and more. Obviously, all the attention has been on Rona right now. With little attention being paid. But what's interesting is, while there's such a fanfare for what's in our face immediate, there are things happening in the background, and we don't want to lose sight of that, you know, mm-hmm. while these things are basically enforced into the new normal. And we need to really break that down and get some insight from some folks in the field who have done their work, who've done their research, who, you know, have a living knowledge about what we're looking at.
And I'll be able to share some keys that my elders have put me up on, like, for instance, remedies like Nebadai seeds.
Nebadai.
Dr. Ando.
Yeah, we have some audio from him, too. Game. Wow.
With the Nebadai, with so much, you know. So there's so much nutritional value here, as well as they purify water, too.
Mm.
What I've heard researched. Mm.
Very exciting.
So,
very exciting.
Definitely a lot to share.
Very exciting. So I'd say, with that, I think we should probably go ahead and sign off. I think our first soft launch has been relatively successful. I feel great.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, nice. Not bad. We see the system is workable. So
it's workable.
Big up to our platform, who will remain unnamed since they're not sponsoring us. But until then, maybe they will in the future.
Blessed love, Dashanya. Saw it look like Gajanan jumped in.
Gajanan jumped in, what?
Different ones and ones.
Okay.
Blessed love to the fam.
For sure. I want to go ahead and play a little audio, though, from B, because we definitely want to big up the artists on the planet. And I know you have a dope EP that came out. Tell people a little bit about that, where they can find it. I'm going to play a track from it, but let them know the name of the EP.
Okay. My EP is called Infinite.
Infinite.
I put it out, I think it was last year on my birthday.
All right.
And just sharing some vibes. It's... a lot of it expresses some of my views, and some R&B vibes. Got some rap on there, a little bit of reggae raga type of vibe, raga.
Okay.
And though it's all like roots, it's real organic. It's an organic feeling to it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And yeah.
We'll definitely, yeah, we'll let people vibe with a track off the EP called All You Need. Love that song.
Yeah,
so
thanks.
We'll let them, just to know all they need, all you need in this time. You know what I'm saying?
That's what's up.
Yeah, I think that's the right note to take it out on. And we will tune in with
you. You
going to
bring the intro back too?
Maybe. We'll be doing
that.
Yeah,
let's hear that first.
Wanna hear that first? All right, let's go.
Give me all you need.
Well, there we go. Apparently all you need is the new intro.
It's the intro.
Okay, that's really all you need. Forget the other stuff.
There we go.
That's funny. this guy. Mm. Oh boy. All right. Well, planet restoration theme, without further ado, fix the frequency. That's the message. That's the method. I want to give a shout out to my brother Wes Whitcamper out there holding it up in Venice Beach. Holding it up. Fix the frequency. Resonating that message out there with the human family. And we'll look forward to having him as one of our correspondents on location.
Yeah,
at the Pacific Ocean. Yeah, stay safe. Stay home.
Sit your ass down.
Sit your ass down somewhere. And meditate, actually. That'll help fix the frequency. Why don't you do that while you're sitting down?
Sit your booty.
Your booty? Your
booty side of it.
Your booty booty. Sit it on down. Take a pause for the cause. And
the booty tree.
And, you know, spread love and spread the word about Planet Restoration Live. We'll be coming to you soon again here in the very near now. And looking forward to, we'll keep you posted, and we'll be sure to give you a little bit more lead time so you can schedule it into your very otherwise busy life sitting at home. So, just kidding. No, I mean, I know we all obviously have a lot to do, and people working remote and doing all kinds of things, got families and children and all sorts of stuff. But, you know, it's important to make time for the divine.
Correct.
And relax your mind. And
if you're feeling it, you can share it.
Yeah.
Team.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Right now, this is like the, for lack of a better word, a viral opportunity, frankly.
Mm-hmm.
But let more love, more meta, let that go viral. That's the real, that's the real frequency.
That's the time it is.
Yes, sir. All right, B, wonderful to connect with you, brother. And
likewise.
We'll link soon. All right.
Yes, sir.
Peace and love to the human family. Fix the frequency.
Something's missing, I'll be there. Surely comforting. There's a message.